Mountain gorillas are rebounding from the brink of extinction, but threats still remain, including human encroachment, climate change, and even poaching. The Ellen DeGeneres campus of the Diane Fossey Gorilla Fund has been established to ensure that conservation continues from generation to generation. Welcome to Doing Business in Rwanda. In this episode, we will tell you the beautiful story of this campus. It is right here in Kinigi, next to the Volcano Mountains. It's a bit cold, but the story is beautiful. I'm your host, Tessie Carvin. Sitting on 12 acres of land, the Ellen DeGeneres campus of the Diane Fossey Gorilla Fund is adjacent to the Volcanoes National Park in Kinigi sector of Musanze District in Rwanda. The research facility will serve as a gateway to conservation for many stakeholders and help to create the next generation of conservationists. It is, however, impossible to tell the story of the Ellen campus without mention of Diane Fossey, a legendary scientist who founded the Karisoke Research Center in Rwanda's Virunga Mountains in 1967 to protect and study the endangered mountain gorillas.
I, as a 12-year-old girl, saw this woman on the cover holding a baby gorilla. And I don't know that I was aware of subliminally what that message was. I think what I saw as a 12-year-old girl was, you know, I loved animals, and I saw a woman that was connecting to animals the way that I connected to animals. And this was not just a cat or a dog, this was a baby gorilla. And she was living in Africa, which I didn't even understand. You know, I'd never been out of New Orleans, and didn't know much about the rest of the world. And then the more I read about her living on a mountain by herself and studying these animals and learning their intelligence, I just saw a very strong, independent woman who was courageous and compassionate. And I think, you know, all that stuff kind of filtered into me without me really understanding the impact. It was just me like, oh, I want to hold a baby gorilla. But those were all the things that I think happened. And as I got older, it was just something that I always wanted to do. I always wanted to come to Rwanda. I always wanted to see her work, what she had done, what she started. And I just was in awe of her and always have been. And then the rest is history.
Apart from honoring the memory of Diane Fossey, who was tragically murdered in December of 1985, the Ellen DeGeneres campus came about as a birthday gift.
Ellen is an incredible woman. She's met the most exceptional people on earth. And so when we first got together, I asked her who her hero was or who she most admired. And I was expecting maybe a sitting president or someone who had been on her show that influenced her, but she thought about it and she said Diane Fossey. And I had obviously heard of Diane Fossey, but I really didn't know her that well. I didn't really know her work. So I think, you know, because of the position that Ellen is in, having met so many incredible people, to have that feeling for this person and to be so inspired by somebody at such a young age and then continue throughout her lifetime, I thought it was important for me to give her a gift that connected her past to her future, because I knew the show was going to be over at some point. And I also knew that I wanted to create a legacy for Ellen.
As the name alludes, the campus will only concentrate on gorillas, with daily protection, scientific research, and the training of conservationists at the very core of the work they do. One would, however, ask, why gorillas, given that there are many other endangered species?
I say there are three reasons. Number one, they need us. They are one of the world's most at-risk species, and so they need our help. There are only 1,000 mountain gorillas left in the world. 1,000, not many at all. Number two, we need them. Gorillas live in the Congo Basin, which is the second largest standing tropical rainforest left on our planet. It is the literal lungs of our planet and one of the best natural defenses against climate change. And so when we protect gorillas, we also protect ourselves. But then I think the third reason is that they deserve it. They share 98% of our DNA and they share our humanity. They take care of their most vulnerable like we do. They form lifelong friendships like we do. They mourn the loss of a family member the same way we do. And so they really deserve a place on this planet.
Apart from benefiting the gorillas, the campus has come as a blessing for the surrounding community.
So the local communities around here, one is they contributed to the building of this place. There were thousands, almost 3,000 people in one way or another that contributed to this. They had jobs, they were able to earn over the 4 years of construction of this project. So that was an immediate need. Also jobs that continue inside here. We have over 500 people that will be employed. They'll do different things. They will do research. They will do support work. They will sell their handicraft. You can see that there's already a corner for art products, which are done by the local communities. They will supply food and drinks that will be consumed by visitors that come here and those that work here. And this is how our local economy works. You build an infrastructure like this, the demand and consumption from the communities just shoots up. And that's why we really support these projects that come to the communities.
Over 2,400 members of the local community were employed during the construction phase of the project, many of them women. For Uwidu Haivestin, this job opportunity was life-changing.
I started out as a helper on the construction site, but the construction company trained us and gave us more skills as they did not want us to remain at the same level we were when we came. So we did the construction work, but also got time for trainings. Working here, I acquired skills and got an income as well. After the completion of the project, I got a certificate in construction, and with the money I got from the project, about 1.5 million rand and francs, I am now a mobile money agent.
The multi-acre eco-friendly research facility includes three main buildings: the Sandy and Harold Price Research Center, the Robe and Melanie Walton Education Center, and the Cindy Broder Conservation Gallery, as well as housing for visiting students and researchers. The beautiful campus stands as another vote of confidence for Rwanda's conservation efforts.
We thank a partner, somebody like Ellen DeGeneres, for choosing Rwanda. It's really important, and it's really something that we appreciate that they chose Rwanda as a place that this building or this campus would come. But I also think that it encourages us and motivates us as a country to keep doing what we're doing, because I believe they chose Rwanda because they saw that we aligned in our vision for conservation, and I think they saw the track record that we have in conserving the mountain gorillas, which, by the way, have now grown by 26%, as the Honorable Prime Minister said. And so I believe that it was a meeting of minds, what they want to do, but in a country that actually also has the same vision, has a track record, and not just for conservation and ecotourism, but also a track record in how we make doing business in the country easy and seamless, in how we also welcome people to come to Rwanda in a very easy and seamless way. I think all this built an ecosystem that has been championed by our president, President Kagame, and the leadership of Rwanda to build this track record and ecosystem.
The state-of-the-art research facility will serve as a regional and international hub for conservation science and will help train the next generation of conservation scientists while addressing some of the glaring gaps in conservation science on the African continent.
It's very committed to advancing the science of how we protect gorillas, how do we address things related to climate change, but also a huge part of it is training that next generation of conservationists, particularly here in Africa. We know that there are a lot of environmental challenges facing our planet, and we need an excited, well-educated group of new leaders, and that's really what we hope to achieve on this campus. I think one of the major gaps still in conservation science in Africa is inequities, that there are still many of the studies that are being done in Africa are not being led by Africans. And we really hope that the campus can contribute to building that generation of African conservationists that are leading conservation on the continent.
Diane Fossey unfortunately did not live to see the gorilla population in the world reach the 1,000 mark, but her work has undeniably inspired the next generation of conservationists. Diane's final diary entry reads, and I quote, "When you realize the value of all life, you dwell less on what is past and concentrate more on the preservation of the future," end of quote. The Ellen DeGeneres campus of the Diane Fossey Gorilla Fund hopes to do just that, preserve the future of mountain gorillas.
That's all we had for this edition of Doing Business in Rwanda. Thank you so much for watching. We would appreciate your feedback. Write to us on Twitter at CNBC Africa or tag me directly at Tessie Carvin. Until next time, bye for now.